morning.
大家早。
To all pastors and everyone.
弟兄姐妹，各位同工，大家早。
My name is Rebecca Lam, cell member of Sophia Tan.
我是 Rebecca， 是 Sophia 的组员。
I came from a moderate family background.
我来自一个普通的家庭。
My father's job needs him to be away from home, and my mom babysits at home, has a side income.
我父亲的工作上的需要呢，他必须要到处去出国，而我妈妈呢就在家里做保姆。
Therefore, my younger sister and I need to share out the housework.
所以很小开始，我跟我妹妹就要开始分担家里的工作。
As the eldest in the family, I was expected to take care of my younger siblings.
作为长女的我呢，我就被期待要照顾好我的妹妹。
Since young, I went to Malay school and I can speak fluent English and Malay. This became an advantage in my career.
自小我就参加国立学校，开始在马来文、在英文上我都很流利，也成了我在职场上的一个优势。
I started as a beauty consultant.
所以我刚开始加入行业是作为一个美容咨询师。
I received training and I worked hard.
我受过训练，我也很殷勤的。
In 3 years, I was being promoted to be a supervisor, taking care of the operations in the KL region.
在三年里面，我就被提升成为整个吉隆坡区域的看管者。
As a supervisor, I need to work long hours, especially during weekends.
甚至来到周末的时候，我的工作时间都必须要很长。
I also have to deal with all the HR matters. I found this really stressful.
也需要面对处理一些人事上的问题，对我而言是非常的困难艰难的。
Then I had an opportunity to become a trainer.
过不久，我就有一个机会可以成为一个训练员。
I no longer need to worry about the stressful human resource planning.
我就不需要去担心那些人事上的问题了。
I find it interesting, even though I need to travel and conduct training all over Malaysia.
即使我的工作需要我到处的去走，去到马来西亚各地给教导呢，但是对我来说，我是觉得是很有兴趣的。
This rekindled my enthusiasm in my job again.
也再一次重燃我在工作上的热忱。
Quickly, I was promoted to a senior trainer, and now,
很快的我就提升成为有资深的训练导师。
I am the assistant manager in charge of beauty education and training.
而我也成为了美容训练部的副经理。
In these 19 years,
在这十九年的工作
，I strive for my achievement and recognition.
我很努力的去达标，去得到认可。
Unknowingly,
在我不知觉之下
my mind was filled with performance and achievements, perfection and recognition.
我脑里满想的就是我的工作表现，我的成绩，认可，还有那个完美。
Eventually, I neglected the most important element in life, that is relationship.
慢慢的，我忽略了在生命里面的关系。
I am proud of my own achievement, and I think I am successful and a capable woman.
我为着我自己所达到的成就，我很感到很骄傲。我觉得我是一个成功的事业女性。
I use my high expectation, my own measurement on others.
我用我的尺，用我的期待来衡量其他人。
I expect my core teams to perform like I do.
我期待我的核心团队能够达到我所要求的。
And there's no reason that they can't perform if I can.
如果我可以做到，那么他们一样也可以做到。
This causes my team to withdraw themselves.
这也导致我的队友呢就跟我有距离。
And hinder our interaction.
开始在我们的互动上有一些的拦阻。
My dominance in getting the job done became a disaster in my life.
我工作上的强势性格呢，成为我生命里面的绊脚石。
Many times my manager called me to talk about the complaints from my subordinates, which I am not aware of.
很多时候我的经理都会跟我谈一谈我下属对我的抱怨。
She suggested that I should improve on my leadership and interaction skill.
我的经理还建议我能够提升我的领导能力，还有的互动能力。
When I heard this, I felt angry and disappointed.
当我听到这些的时候，我都觉得很生气，也很失望。
Because none of them confronted me.
因为即使有那么多的抱怨，没有一个人来正面的跟我对质。
I can't understand and could not accept this.
我完全不明白为什么会有这样的抱怨，而我也不能够接受。
Because I don't have any bad intention. All I'm doing is for the benefits of the team and the company.
我所做的并没有任何的其他的目的，我要的就是为公司的好，队友的好。
This is so unfair.
所以我觉得很不公平。
Outwardly, I would still appear be strong, as though nothing happened.
表面上我看起来很坚强，没有事情发生。
But my face will show, and I will stop talking with them for a few days.
但是我脸上就会表露出我的不悦，甚至有几天我都不会跟我的团队们说话。
Inwardly, I feel a loneliness in my heart.
而在我内心，我感到的是孤寂。
I long for a true friend.
我期待一个真心的朋友。
Who can understand my situation and can talk my heart out without faking?
是可以明白我的状况，并且可以跟我真心交谈的。
So last April 2017, I was invited by my sister to GA 611.
去年2017年四月的时候，我的妹妹就邀请我来到了 GA.
It was the feast of Passover, and I was drawn to the statement "a renewed relationship."
那个时候正是逾越节，然后有一句话吸引了我，更新的关系。
From the message, I understood that God is love, is unconditional.
透过信心，我就明白神的爱是毫无条件的。
God accept me as I am, not because of what I've done or my success.
神接纳我，并不是因为我的成绩或者是我所做的，乃是因为我本相。
I accepted Jesus as my Savior on that day.
所以那一天我就接受耶稣成为我个人的救主。
Church life is an eye-opening to me.
教会的生活对我来说是一个简直是大开眼界。
People are genuine. They share their true feelings. They talk about their happiness and sadness, failure and success without the fear of how people see them.
教会的人都很真诚，他们能够分享他们的真感觉，无论是开心，无论是伤心，即使是他们的失败，他们的成功，他们都可以毫无惧怕的分享出来。
They are so true and they are real to one another.
在我眼中，他们是彼此真诚、彼此真心的。
I desire to have this true relationship.
我很期待有这样的一个真诚的关系。
The church core value, God first, man second, then the earth brings a great impact in me.
而教会的核心价值，先神后人，在大地大大的影响了我。
I decided to change the way, my way of conduct.
所以我决定要改变我做事的方式。
Putting people more important than my job.
开始看重关系胜过我的工作。
I learned to be quick to listen and slow to speak.
我学习快快的听，慢慢的说。
Giving space for others to express their thoughts.
给机会他人有机会来分享他们的想法。
I become a more happy, more tolerant, and more understanding person.
我开始成为一个更有喜悦、更有忍耐力、更加明白事理的人。
My working environment still unchanged.
工作环境仍然一样。
The situation, the problems are still the same.
面对的问题还是一样。
The people working with me remain the same.
跟我一起同工的同事们还是一样。
But the only change is.The joyful feeling deep in me.
而唯一的改变就是我心中里面的一份的喜悦。
These changes are noticeable.
而这个改变是显而易见的。
My colleagues commented about me lately, saying that I look happier and easy and not easily overreacted to matter anymore.
而我的同事就会跟我说，我看起来更开朗了，并且不会对一些小小事情过分的反应。
I thank God for the reconciliation with Him through Jesus.
所以我很感谢耶稣，透过耶稣，我跟神有一个恢复的关系。
This brings the reconciliation for me with man.
让我跟人的关系当中也有一个恢复。
This unconditional love encouraged me to change.
这个毫无条件的爱呢，鼓励我，帮助我改变。
I thank the church for the teaching.
我也感谢教会的教导
，for the cell group, for their true relationship and friendship.
还有在在小组里面真诚的团契。
I no longer feel lonely.
我不再感觉孤单。
Finally, I am overflowing with love.
然后让我生命里面充满了许许多多的爱。
Not only I have found a spiritual home, I have also created a new atmosphere at my workplace.
我不单只是找到了我的属灵的家，我也在我的职场上制造了一个全新的氛围。
Yes, all glory to and honor to our living God in heaven.
一切的荣耀尊荣归给我们在天上的父。